Marilyn, how do you feel about your work being seen by children? Or your more sexually?
Well, I never made my work for children.
What if a child had come across
something? I was
thinking
about this. It's such a complicated issue. And, sex is one of those things where the minute you try and put any kind of paradigms on it, that just hands you your ass, It's there's an exception to every rule. And I think that, when do you think about sex the most? Maybe when you're 15, And it's very, very complicated. But I'm sure it's very confusing for a 12-year-old or 11-year-old to see, sexual imagery. It's, children, there's a few things, that are just clearly off limits. Nobody would argue that you can't abuse children. You can't. That's abuse if they are in films or used in films, and animals too. I think that makes sense. It just is reasonable. But I wonder all the time: are we? Is pornography supposed to be sort of forbidden? Because is it sexier? That's like sort of you want it to be kind of dirty, don't you? For your own pleasure, but then at this, I hate the idea that there's any kind of censorship. I mean, I believe you fight hate speech with good speech, but I really want people to get it out. I don't want them to act out. I want them to be able to talk about it. I want the dialogue to be constantly open. I think the repression just keeps everything distorted. And, I want the sun to shine, on everything. So human sexuality, human behavior it's tricky. I don't have these answers. In my generation, maybe people, maybe we do need our porn to be sort of illicit, but maybe the new generation, sexting, that makes sense to me. They're thinking about it all the time. So I don't have the answers.
Hi, thank you for coming and speaking on this panel. This question.
Can you speak into the mic?
Sorry. I was just wondering if you could speak a little bit more, Professor Adler, on how different administrations change censorship and the rulings on censorship, and to what extent that has changed over time, and especially because we will have different administrations in the future, where you think that might go, and if it will ever go beyond just being characterized by a specific administration. Thank you.
I mean, I can tell you as an example that under the Bush administration, John Ashcroft came in after the Attorney General at the time came in and said he wanted to make the prosecution of obscenity his top priority, and so gave directions to the Department of Justice to tell their prosecutors around the country to start prosecuting obscenity again. It's sort of at that level where an Attorney General, perhaps in consultation with a president or who knows, will then send the message to the centralized Department of Justice, who will then send the message to federal prosecutors around the country. But it certainly does vary, and different priorities preoccupy different administrations. To the Clinton administration, the number one priority became child pornography and prosecuting child pornography, and they basically decided to let obscenity, adult pornography, fall by the wayside. The Bush administration thought they could do both, and I'm not so sure yet where the Obama Justice Department is headed.
I have a question for Andrew and Neville, and it's kind of, why do you think there's so little pleasure in Districted and so much frustration?
Yeah, that's a great question.
It's all about failure. It's clear, it's because it's art.
What Districted says about art as opposed to what it says about porn. Says about art world and the rules of art. And in those terms, the frustration.
I'm not sure, actually. I think, I certainly don't think that there was any kind of self-censorship going on in terms of eroticism or visualization of sexual pleasure. I think I think a lot of people elected to take a sort of more documentary approach to it. Richard would be one. He took the existing language rather than create their own language out of it. So I think, with the exception,
which one was his?
The 70s.
Richard Prince's was the 70s.
It was the
footage.
The doctor.
The film of the television.
The film with the doctor and the nurse. Yeah, an encounter.
The sexy one.
I guess.
So I think the challenge for a lot of people, and not everyone met it, or not everyone chose to meet it, was how do you create a different type of sexual language out of this, this sort of continent of sexual imagery that we live with.
I mean, it was interesting to me comparing to a film that, I don't know whether the audience knows it, Carolee Schneemann made a film, kind of an art film about sex in the 60s. And that film was, she had herself and her then husband videotaped while they were having sex from the point of view of their cat. And then she baked the film, and then she was showing the film. It's been much censored, but It's a very direct film. You can see her, you can see the artist in the film, you can see her engaging in real sex with her husband. It's very vulnerable. To me, like, Districted did not have this kind of vulnerability. That it was, a lot of it, the Richard Prince was at one remove. This is about porn. This is not about me and sex. It's about porn. It's about something else. It's very removed from the intimacy and the vulnerability of sexuality.
Well, I mean, I think in response to that, we were inviting people to make works that were, for public consumption in some way, and I think the idea that kind of intimacy that you're talking about can be translated into the public sphere without a degree of objectification or whatever is maybe the thing that's problematic.
Is it an issue of, I mean, wouldn't there be a little bit of perhaps even unconscious self-censorship in this, whether you can display yourself or whether once it's in the public sphere you have to remove sexuality? I mean, to me, it's like an issue of what art is about right now.
Well, I don't think we're removing sexuality. I think it's about removing intimacy.
Art is still in metaphor. They don't want to spell things out for you. Otherwise, it just becomes an illustration.
No. Of course, it's a metaphor. But it's this kind of removal of the artist. You're making something about sexuality, but it's not...
It's multi-layered.
But the artist is not...
Yeah, it's not really for... I don't really give any of those, except for Richard's. Mm-hmm. They weren't made for purposes of self-pleasuring. I don't think, anyway. Might be wrong.
I mean, I'm not sure what the question is. Whether it's a question about their lack of...
Lack of hotness?
it's more like the lack of... The lack of exposure in this sense of the artist not being seen as vulnerable and involved in these, but being a very kind of intellectual remove from intimacy.
The work strikes me very defended. The thing I kept asking myself is, what are these people afraid of, that they keep putting things between themselves and then feel like the audience also wants to have that between. If it's not an internalization of the, it has to make you throw up to be art, so then what is it?
And people think my film...
Yeah, yours was the yours was the least intermediated
makes
by...
Makes you gag.
But it was
well, there
the
is
least,
a sheet of glass.
Totally art.
It was right there, but all the rest of them, either there was crap spread all over the guy, or there was
well, that wasn't crap, that was...
Stuff.
Sperm. Yeah.
But it was all this kind of layering to like protect the artist or the audience from the
Well, art the deals with metaphor always, I think. I mean,
but what is that a metaphor for, is what I'm trying to figure out.
Oh, desire? You know, I like the idea artists are always interpreting the times they live in. And it's never, I don't think any of those people, you know, really were making art for pleasure purposes. They were trying to make a picture of what porn is, not making anything to turn you on. Does that make sense? Yeah.
Well, on that note, I'd like to thank our panel for coming and being here with us.